Hi, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to explain you how to install PyTorch in your Raspberry Pi device. First of all, you need to be sure that you are running a 64 OS version in your Raspberry device. If you don't have that, you need to install a new version or update the version you had. The easiest way to do this, and is how I did it, because well, recently I bought a Raspberry Pi 5 and it's coming by default with a 32 version. And then, as I said, I want to install a PyTorch. And then, what I did is pretty simple. You go to the raspberrypi.com/software page, you download the Pi Imager software, you just download the suitable version, the suitable application for your desktop or laptop. I had a Windows machine, so I download the Windows version. Then on you run the once you install it, you just run the software, you choose your device. I had a Raspberry Pi version 5. I choose the OS. I recommend you what you have here. Version is a quick a shortcut to a 64 or 32, but I recommend you go here and choose the desktop version because this comes with a graphic environment. This is the full version, is what I installed. And then on choose the storage. I had a SD card of 32 gigabytes. Click next. You can set up some configuration for your device. This is like the host name, username and password for to log in your device, and also for SSH, the wireless configuration, and also the local settings. Also, you can choose here if you want to enable SSH. I strongly recommend you to do that because later on we will access to the device using SSH and install Conda and PyTorch through the SSH connection. And this option, well, this is completely optional. Save. And then you apply this to the OS setup. You want to erase the USB, the storage device, yes, and then start to write. I'm going to pause here. This take around about 10 minutes after it's finished. When it's finished, I will continue with the video. Here, just I want to show you now it's writing on the SD card, and well, once it's finished. The writing process is start to do a verification of the software in your booting device, and after that the process finish. Once the writing process finish, start the verifications. It will take as well a while, couple of minutes, so when it finish I will come back. Okay, now as you see the process finishes. Just the what we need to do is just remove the card from the reader and plug it into your Raspberry Pi device. Let's continue, and then on I will finish this tutorial here, and later I will record a second part of this tutorial. And see you soon.